Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonsom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 38th of September. Indian court accused all 32 accused in Babri Mosque demolition case. Activists rebukes Pakistan, China over illegal construction of dams in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. And US envoy Khalilzad heads to Doha, says progress in intra-Afghan talks expected. And now for all the details. Almost 28 years after the Babri Mosque demolition, an Indian court on Wednesday acquitted all 32 accused individuals in the case. The court said the demolition was not pre-planned and ruled out the conspiracy theories in the December 1992 incident in which the Mughal era monument was razed to ground by a mob of religious volunteers.
A special CBI Central Bureau of Investigation court in India's northern Lucknow city acquitted all accused in the Babri Mosque demolition case. The court ruled that the CBI had not been able to establish that there was conspiracy theories in the December 1992 incident in which the Mughal era monument was razed to ground by a mob of religious volunteers. The demolition was not pre-planned, but a spontaneous act primarily carried out by mischievous elements, the court said. Veteran leaders of India's ruling Bharatiya Janata Party, L.K. Advani, Murli Manohar Joshi and Uma Bharti were among the 32 accused acquitted in the case. Soon after the verdict, political reactions started flooding in with BJP leaders hailing it. However, India's opposition Congress Party said the verdict runs counter to the Supreme Court's November 9 ruling and the constitutional spirit.
स्पेशल कोर्ट का आज का जो निर्णय हुआ है वह अत्यंत महत्वपूर्ण है और हम सब के लिए बहुत खुशी का प्रसंग है जब यह समाचार सुना जय श्री राम कह करके हमने इसका स्वागत किया
द डिसीजन ऑफ द स्पेशल कोर्ट टुडे To acquit all the accused in Babri Masjid demolition case runs counter to the Supreme Court judgment as also the constitutional spirit.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi had last month laid the foundation stone for a Hindu temple to be built at the site after the Supreme Court paved the way last year in a decision that also ordered land to be allotted further away for a mosque.
India recorded 80,472 new coronavirus cases in the last 24 hours, taking the total number of infections to over 6.2 million on Wednesday, with 97,497 deaths reported so far. According to the Health Ministry, the country's recovery rate is 83.33%, the highest in the world with over 5.1 million recoveries. However, Indian Council of Medical Research on Tuesday said a second serological survey conducted in India in August and September showed a large percentage of population had not been exposed to the coronavirus and is still vulnerable and susceptible. A day after the victim of Hathras gang rape case in India's northern Uttar Pradesh state succumbed to her injuries, protests demanding justice for her erupted in the country. The victim's family alleged her body was cremated by police forcefully on Tuesday night. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has called for the strictest action against the accused in the incident.
Protests in India's northern Uttar Pradesh state erupted on Wednesday morning after local police in Hathras city allegedly cremated a gang rape victim's body without her family's consent on Tuesday night. The victim, who died in capital New Delhi's Safdarjung Hospital on Tuesday, had suffered multiple fractures, paralysis and a gash in her tongue in the horrific assault. She was cremated by policemen forcefully on Tuesday night, allegedly as her family and relatives were locked up in their homes. Police has denied the allegations.
तब मेरी ओम प्रकाश जी से और इनके जो बेटे हैं उनसे बात हुई थी और उन्होंने सहमति दी थी कि रात को अंतिम संस्कार कर दिया जाए. उसके बाद जब यहाँ पर आया तो जो शव वाहन था उसके आगे लगभग 4-5 महिलाएं लेट गई थी और मैं तुरंत से, क्योंकि मैं यहीं पे था 200-300 मीटर की दूरी पे, मैं तुरंत से आया और 10-15 मिनट हमारी बात हुई. उसके बाद शव वाहन को इनके घर पे लाया और लगभग 1-1.25 घंटे वहाँ पे खड़ा रहा और उसके बाद इन्हीं की सहमति से उसका अंतिम संस्कार किया गया है.
Meanwhile, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi has called for the strictest action against the accused in the incident, Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath informed in a tweet on Wednesday. Adityanath asserted a 3-member panel has been set up to investigate the case, which will submit a report in the next 7 days. He has also asked for the trial to be conducted in a fast-track court. Local police in Uttar Pradesh is under scrutiny over alleged lapses throughout the case. Family of the victim alleged the police initially registered an attempted to murder case on September 14, the date of the crime, but added rape charges only after the woman's formal statement.
Moving on, a political activist lambasted Pakistan and China for illegally constructing mega dams in the occupied territory of Pakistan-administered Kashmir while speaking during the UNHRC session in Geneva this week. He highlighted rampant destruction of natural resources and exploitation of common public through so-called development projects in the region.
Political activist Nasir Aziz Khan lambasted Pakistan and China at the 45th session of UN Human Rights Council in Geneva this week for illegally constructing mega dams in the occupied territory of Pakistan-administered Kashmir. In his intervention, he said Pakistan and China are violating UN resolutions as they are rampantly destroying natural resources in both Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan through so-called developmental projects which only serve their interests and essentially aim to further suppress and marginalize the locals in the illegally occupied territories.
Our natural resources are being exploited instead of being giving ownership and paying royalty to natives. Islamabad receiving hefty surcharge from the local consumer through monthly electric bill in the name of these projects.
Nasir Aziz Khan also raised concerns over draconian laws which ban political parties and activists in the illegally occupied territories who do not endorse accession to Pakistan and urged UN to intervene. He highlighted those who oppose or expose the nefarious designs of Islamabad are subjected to surveillance, harassment, imprisonment and even killed.
Moving on. U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad on Wednesday said that he is headed back to Doha, where the Afghan government and the Taliban negotiators are struggling to finalize ground rules for talks. He said he will meet with both sides as Afghan people are expecting progress.
U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad on Wednesday said that he is headed back to Doha, as the negotiating team of Afghan government and the Taliban are struggling to finalize ground rules for talks. In a series of tweets, Khalilzad said he will meet with the partners on peace negotiations and prospects for increased regional connectivity, trade and development following peace, as the international community and the Afghan people are expecting the teams to make progress. The contact groups of both sides have discussed the rules many times over the last 20 days, but have not reached an agreement, and critics suggest that a mediator might be needed in the negotiations. Meanwhile, Abdullah Abdullah, the chairman of Afghan High Council for National Reconciliation, on Tuesday met with Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan in Islamabad and discussed the peace process among other issues of bilateral interest. Afghanistan and its international allies have for years accused Pakistan of backing Taliban as a way to limit the influence of old rival India in Afghanistan, and the country is seen vital for success of peace talks as it enjoys leverage with the insurgent group.
During Taliban's rule in Afghanistan, women's activities including sports were curbed. Despite radical Islamic undercurrent which still pervades, Afghan women are now managing to rebuild their lives and identities. A young Afghan female mountaineer is planning next summit to show the world what she can do. 18-year-old Fatima Sultani gazes at the peak of a mountain near Afghanistan's capital Kabul after completing a morning climbing session, considering her next steps. She and her team of 9 young Afghan mountaineers, 3 of them women, are hoping to climb Afghanistan's Mir Samir mountain and after that travel to Nepal to summit the world's highest peak, Mount Everest. Sultani had continued to climb throughout the coronavirus pandemic in August, making it to the summit of 7,492 meters altitude Noshak Peak, one of the hardest climbs in the world, in the Hindu Kush mountain range in northern Afghanistan.
ما هدف اصلی ما امی است که ما به تمام جهانیان نشان بدیم که بانوان افغانستان هم قدرتمند هستند میتونن کارهای سختی را که مثلا مردای ما انجام بدن ما میتونیم انجام بدیم و بالخصوص ما وقتی که خبر میشدیم که از کشورهای خارج مثلا میایند در افغانستان قله های مرتفع افغانستان اینا فتح میکنن بانوانشان ما واقعا به این فکر رسیدیم چرا وقتی که قله های افغانستان داخل کشور خود ماست ما خود ما نمیتونیم ما بانو نمی
But as the Islamist Taliban hold peace talks with the Afghan government in Doha, many fear that they may curb women's activities, including in sport, as they did during their rule. Though the Taliban say they have changed, their public statements on women's rights have been vague and many harbor concerns. In the 6th meeting of India-Bangladesh Joint Consultative Commission chaired by respective foreign ministers on Tuesday, New Delhi and Dhaka reviewed full range of bilateral cooperation including expanding connectivity in the road, rail, inland waterways and ports.
India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar and Bangladeshi counterpart A.K. Abdul Momen jointly chaired the 6th meeting of the Joint Consultative Commission held on a virtual platform on Tuesday. India and Bangladesh reviewed the expanding connectivity in the road, rail, inland waterways and ports and agreed to expedite progress in ongoing projects besides. They expressed their commitment to take forward cooperation in the energy sector, including third-party projects, and reaffirmed their shared commitment to a peaceful and secure border. Jaishankar announced that India will release a commemorative stamp on 16th December this year on the birth centenary of Bangabandhu, Bangladesh's founding leader. He also announced the setting up of Bangabandhu Babu Digital Museum to commemorate the 150 years of Indian freedom fighter Mahatma Gandhi and the historic Mujib Barsho. Reiterating India's commitment to prioritize the supply of COVID-19 vaccines, Jaishankar emphasized the importance of Bangladesh in India's neighborhood first policy. The early return to normalcy in trade and travel affected by COVID-19 was discussed.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Nepal has reopened some schools amid the coronavirus pandemic, keeping in mind the health safety protocols of wearing masks and maintaining social distance. The new academic session in Nepal, which usually starts from May or June, got delayed by months due to the pandemic.
Amid the COVID-19 pandemic and strict guidelines to curb the spread of the deadly virus, the playgrounds in Nepal schools are now seen with youngsters donning masks and sustaining social distance as authorities have allowed few schools to reopen. New educational session, which often begins from May or June in Nepal, was delayed by months this year because of the pandemic.
Khushi lagira cha ab padhai haru continue garna payo pahila ta continue ni garna pathina aisi ni huncha ki hudaina bhanne tension ni bhairathyo aba continue garna payo.
Meanwhile, authorities amid the surge in coronavirus cases across the Himalayan nation have enforced odd-even rules for vehicles to contain the infection spread. However, traffic volume in Kathmandu Valley has increased with the arrival of the annual Dashain festival. In Nepal, as of Wednesday, around 76,250 cases of the novel coronavirus were confirmed and at least 20,396 people had lost their lives due to the infection.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter @AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.